Okay, here we are back in Resident Evil. Now it's time to do real survival mode. New costume has been unlocked. And it's this one. So let's lock in and get going. So, since we're on real survival, I'm going to assume you've already watched the other videos, or you're somewhat familiar with the storyline.
There are only three stars.
I will be cutting out the scenes because I may need the time to move back and forth between different item chests. For those that aren't aware about how real survival works, the item boxes are not linked. That is the key difference, number one. Number two is, you may have noticed that there was no difficulty selector at the beginning of the video. The reason for that is because real survival, I believe, is automatically locked in at the hardest difficulty possible. So it's not just bad enough that there are no item box links, but the other changes are in effect as well. I don't know if it's just that the zombies deal more damage, if they take more shots, or what, but that's the gist of it. Additionally, there is no more auto-aim. So this means I have to manually aim my shots, and some shots may be going into the wall because I can't aim properly. Additionally, you won't be able to see when enemies are dead unless there's a pool of blood under them. Otherwise, when auto-aim is enabled, you can just go into your attack stance and it'll zero in on the enemies that are still alive for you. And on this playthrough, I'm not going to be aiming for the 3-hour time limit, more just a survival thing. That also means I can't make any promises about what ending I'll go for, I'm just going to try to beat this mode. I don't really know as much about real survival mode as much as the normal mode, which is why I'm not as comfortable here. I'm bound to make a mistake here and there. Okay, a steam pop-up distracted me there. So I'm bound to make a mistake here and there. I may be looking for items that aren't here on hard mode. So to give you an example, there was no magazine by the birdcage like there were in the previous playthroughs. Defensive items will also be harder to come by, making them all the more precious. And the real kicker is, it's going to be hard to move the canteen around, which means I have to be really selective with what zombies I kill. And right there he should have had me, I'd say, but I kind of glitched out or something. I may need the blue gem, which is why I'm going to try to pull the zombie over here. I want him on this side for when I push it. But for real survival, you don't have to deal with the broken doorknob. That's the one saving grace for you, since you may have to be moving back and forth between different areas for the sake of moving items. They don't punish you that way. But now if I need 6 more shotgun shells, that route is open to me. And I won't deny that my voice is kind of shot at the moment. I'm probably going to record one part of this before I wait until I recover. But with the gold arrow in our pockets, we now need to go get the sword key. Trying to pull this zombie off to the side so I can run around him. I'm going to stick to the outside wall here to avoid triggering that zombie, which I may have failed to do. It's hard enough to game past one zombie here. Hopefully I didn't trigger both. Otherwise I may have to take a hit. And to make things worse, I don't actually know where or if my bonus items are even in this, such as my closet key to change costume, or even my samurai edge or infinite rocket launcher. I would not be surprised if neither of them are in this mode, to be honest. Anyway, we have the sword key, now we can try to get to the other half of the mansion, get to the first save room to get the canteen. And while I wait to... Shit. Get off! So I had no way of seeing where that zombie was, and I ended up taking the hit. That's gonna knock me down to caution. Not the end of the world. I'll heal later. But I have to say that the costume I'm using right here is probably my least favorite costume for Chris. The non-Resident Evil ones, I think, are inferior to the actual Resident Evil ones. And crud, I didn't mean to go in this door. I wasn't really paying attention. We need to come from the other way. So if my closet key is indeed in this mode, you have to access the closet through the room over here. But I have the new costume, so I'm just gonna keep going as is, leaving the map where it is also. There should be a dagger back there, but it's not worth it. In my experience, you end up having to use the dagger just to get out of that area when the zombie appears behind you, so... yeah. And here is our first defensive item. I believe I have those on manual so they won't get wasted. And the magazine that was under this cabinet or buffet thing is not here in this mode, I think. I'm gonna push it 3 times just to make sure. And you see there's nothing there. This isn't really too much of a bad thing because we don't use the handgun as much on Chris just because it's not that good of a weapon. But the real kicker is that some of the shotgun's ammo spawns have changed down to handgun. So by extension we may have fewer rounds that way. But since we're Chris we have to deal with the old key nonsense. And we need to go grab the herbicide. So we need to get the herbicide here. It's worth the old key. And if we don't get it now, then we have to get past the bathroom zombie roaming the hallway, which is not ideal. Anyway, now it's time to heal. Going to take the herbs here as a replacement healing item. combine these for space. And we're grabbing the herbicide so we only have to deal with the dogs. And here comes our zombie friend out of the bathroom. I don't remember where he stands. We need to come back for the shotgun, but we'll worry about it then. As for right now, we're at about the 11-minute mark. And if you're wondering what I'm doing with the zombie, I was just killing time while I wait for him to get on the staircase. We're gonna run past him, and we're gonna get the canteen. I don't know if he keeps the knife damage, that would be nice, but I'm approaching this with near minimum expectations. So I need to fill my canteen and grab the old key. And we need to fill the canteen now. Now, I don't remember what side this zombie faces. And it looks like I kind of got lucky there. And since he's in a crappy spot, I'm taking some shots at his head. Now, we don't see blood pooling under him yet. Now I do. So he's down for the count. Now we didn't need to get the other one. And we're gonna try to stab him as he comes close, just like the other one. I'm not seeing him. Due to the harder difficulty, the zombies will be turning into crimson heads more quickly, so time is of the essence. And the way you can test if a zombie is down for the count is just, can you burn them? If you can, they're not getting up. So that one's out. And now so is this one. We need to go refill our canteen, though. As for right now, I need enough inventory space to pick up the dog whistle. So this is a pretty undesirable situation right now. For me to take the handgun and kill the dogs, I have to leave something here behind. I need the mansion key and the old key to get to them. I need the herbicide. This is probably the one that's most expendable. I'd have to come back for it, even though it'd be nice to get it over on the other side, just so I can do it more quickly later. So the bottle of kerosene there is now empty. I'm going to burn one guy in the hallway and then one over by the infirmary, just to simplify things. And the one by the infirmary is a maybe. Right now I'm trying to think of what zombies would be best to burn, because I could just... And you can see he's not actually down. Now I'm kind of hoping he's down for the count because I did a large ammo investment into him. So we're going to reset the zombie positions and then come back into this hallway so we can get the dog whistle. If that zombie is still standing, we're in really bad shape. Then I have to hope the damage carries over and I can kill him in one or two shots. Okay, he's down. He's a little bit more aggressive than normal. But I think I'm gonna go swap out the canteen for the herbicide. Here's our dog whistle. The magazine that I'm gonna need for the dogs. And we're going out this way so I can get back into the save room. Sadly, the key trait of real survival is the trips like this, where you have to go back to get something that you had to leave behind. If you're wondering why I want the herbicide over there already, it's going to come in handy for when I have to do the antidote run for Richard. I think my goal here is going to be get the armor key, then maybe find a place to save. I'm not even sure if there's ink ribbons in that one room, to be honest. I didn't really look. And if you're wondering why I need to save at all, main thing is I don't have enough time to play through the entire game in one sitting. Plus, it also doesn't help my voice. Well, you can hear my voice. It's a little bit weaker than normal. And the old key from the other save room, we need to open this room to get to the dogs. Now, the bad news is we don't actually know when the dog's around the corner. And I fully intend to leave that other dog alive. My health is good enough to where I can just leave, I hope. Got kind of lucky that it only took 4 bullets to kill the one dog. Now that's the guy I wanted to burn, to be honest. His placement is a little bit different than normal. As for the zombie right here, I don't know if he's in front of the infirmary or what. He's not, so we're good. And there's our closet key. Is there no ink ribbon here? Okay, that could be a bit of a bad thing. Let's go get the armor key. That will trigger the crimson head, sadly, but... Shit! Of all the shitty placements, wow. So, that was just bad luck. That zombie on the ground floor kind of moves around a bit. If he's not in your way, you're sitting pretty. If he is in the way, uh-oh. And if you're wondering why I'm still carrying this gun, I want to leave it in the other item box. So next trip over there, I'll probably ditch it. Right now I'm trying to figure out which would be the best way to return to the dining room, the Crimson Head hallway or through the infirmary. And I'm thinking I'd rather take my chances down the infirmary route. I think the one zombie will pop out from the balcony though. That's kind of why I wanted to burn one of the zombies up here. Looks like he's on the other side. That's good for us. And we're almost far enough in to where I can put a break in the video. I have 2 inventory spots. So I'm going to grab the ink ribbon here in the dining room just in case. I don't know if that means I only have these 3 saves in the mansion until I can find more, but... Otherwise, my other inventory spot is going to be used for the death mask. Going to pull the one from the armor room, and hopefully I have the combination right this time, unlike the Jill game. I am also going to use the armor key on Forest's door. I'm gonna head out there. I don't know if there's anything actually out here, but I may get lucky with a dagger. I'm not gonna go far enough out to where I actually trigger Forest, of course. So nothing on the table, that's to be expected. Dagger. And that's the whole reason we came out here. Our health is not really much of an issue right now because we can use Rebecca to heal us a couple times. I don't remember all the specifics of how that works, if it's like once per room or something, but we'll figure it out. And I don't want to trigger Richard's thing this video, so I'm just going to unlock the door and then keep running. I guess I could do is get the wind crest before I go, or end the video. Now let's see, top right, bottom left, bottom right. I had it the other way around for Jill. This is number 2. And if we're right, number 4 is going to pop into place on its own. And the other half of the heart. Even if I want to go in there, I just don't have the inventory space at the moment. I will take a peek in there before ending the video. Wesker left us a few things. I think it's just handgun ammo, sadly. No shotgun shells, unless I'm mistaken. Yeah, Wesker, you cheap bastard. Let's drop that one there. And I am going to go in there with nothing in my inventory, just so I can maximize my hull coming out in case there's stuff I can get. Worst come to worst, there should be more ink ribbons, I hope. I can't remember if there's an old key in the room or not, that's the main thing. Worst come to worst, it's only going to be like 2 minutes, and since I'm skipping the scenes, that's a lot less detrimental than normal. Of course it would suck if there's a zombie in here. So, there's our red herb. No zombie. Thank you. And I have the option of saving this old key for the whole antidote run, but... I think I'd rather get the wind crest right now and try to just time things correctly. Bit of a big if for me, I know. So, let's go ahead and get our wind crest. We need our bee specimen. We need our hook. And now we need our bee. Just yet. No. Didn't mean to examine that. Now we push the button. Shit, I just picked it up, didn't I? Put that back. Push the button. I don't know how much magnum ammo is in the game, which is why we have to basically save what little we can muster. It's also why I'm probably not going to pick up the magnum until my second trip from Lisa's place. Basically, I'd leave that in her little cabin until I'm ready to leave for good. So there's a small key in the kitchen, and a small key in that one bedroom, I believe. So we'll toss these in the box, save, and then we'll pick up here next time, doing the antidote run for Richard. So, real survival has begun. And we'll have to see how badly we botch this up in the end. You'll even notice the different color text. Ooh. Anyway, I'm the Hero of Light. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.